Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's look at 7 different ways that you could adjust the color on your Mac's display. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 700 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. Now you can make adjustments to your Mac's display to display things a little different. If the colors look a little off to you, or you'd rather be brighter or darker or a little warmer or cooler, all these ways I'm going to show you can be done on your Mac without installing any extra software. And everything we're going to do is going to be in System Preferences. So let's go in there. And the obvious place to start is to go to Displays. Now in Displays there's a Color tab here. So let's go to that. And this will allow you to set the display profile. Now you're going to see a bunch of different things here. What you see is going to be different than what I see. You get these profiles when you install software, when you attach different types of screens to your Mac, and you kind of build up a list of them over time. You could try some of these to see how it changes the colors on your screen, and you'll should see sometimes slight adjustments, sometimes pretty major ones. Now you can also go and create your own profile. So you can do that by hitting Calibrate here, and then it will walk you through all these different steps to calibrate your screen. When you're done, you can name this and save it, and it will appear here in the list. Now there's no right or wrong way to go and use a display profile or to calibrate. It all depends on how you see things, the type of screen you've got. Obviously if you've got a Mac Pro or a Mac Mini, you've got an external display. They could be made by many different companies and they could display colors in different ways. For me it really doesn't matter too much, but for a lot of people that are into design, they care a lot about their display profile. Now there's also night shift here. So night shift is a way to actually reduce the amount of blue light coming out of your screen. You can test it out by using this slider here. So I can adjust it and I could see something close to what it looks like normally on the left, but it's definitely going to look a lot redder and warmer to the right. And then if I wanted to turn it on permanently, I would need to set a custom schedule and have it always on. Otherwise I could set it to only be on at night, or I could have it manually turned on right now and it'll be on for the time being until tomorrow morning. Now another way to adjust colors isn't to actually make screen adjustments, but to use dark mode. If I turn on dark mode, it's going to change the user interface on a lot of apps. All of the Apple apps will go dark with light text. Third party apps, some of them support dark mode, some of them don't. The same thing for web pages. Some will support dark mode, some won't. But it definitely does change the colors of your Mac in a very specific way. You could also set to auto so that during the day it's in light mode and at night it'll change to dark mode. Now another way to change colors on your Mac is to change the accent and highlight colors. So if I were to change the accent color, say to purple, you could see it reflected here in System Preferences. So you can see how the outline here is now in purple. In other apps, you have to look really carefully. Sometimes apps barely show any difference. So for instance here in the Notes app, you can see now that I have set to purple, I've got this highlight here that's purple. And if I were to select something here, you could see that highlight's purple. I can change the highlight color independent of the accent color. So if I want the highlight color to be, say, orange, but keep the accent color purple, I can. Now you can see this orange highlight here, and even this highlight's an orange. Also you can see the highlights of menu items stays purple. So accent color here, highlight color here. Now for other color changes we'll have to go into accessibility. In there we can click on display, and under display we see several different ways to change colors. One is we can increase contrast, and this increases the contrast of the whole display. So you can see here the text is very dark now as opposed to kind of the light gray. The same for the borders and outlines and stuff. You can see here how that really does change how Notes looks. We could turn it off and we could see it like that. We could also reduce transparency and watch the menu bar here at the top. You can see how that becomes completely opaque now instead of a little transparent showing some of the color from the background. You can also adjust display contrast here, changing the contrast almost to the point where it's impossible to use from normal. So that's another way to play with the colors. A really extreme way would be to use invert colors. So invert colors inverts the entire screen. This is really meant for people with a vision disability where it's actually easier to read text and see other things with the entire screen inverted. Now a way to directly change the colors on your screen is color filters right here. Now if you enable color filters, then the filter type here will apply to your whole screen. In grayscale, all the color is gone. But I could also change it to some of these other things, like for instance a red-green filter here. Now I can go to color tint. I can select the color and the entire screen is going to be tinted that color, and I can set the intensity for that tint. Now what you're going to get really depends on your screen. For instance, on my third-party LG screen attached to my Mac Pro, color tinting doesn't even seem to do much of anything. But on my MacBook Pro, of course using Apple's built-in display, there's quite a difference. Now we also shouldn't overlook changing the desktop background, because a lot of times what you're looking at, the colors that you're taking in with your eye, really are all about what the background is. That's the majority of what you're seeing all the time. The background's always there. So going into Desktop and Screensaver and changing the desktop picture really could change the whole look of your Mac. But also remember that things like the menu bar are semi-transparent. So the desktop background is going to change the color there. For instance, let's choose a solid color as a desktop background. If I go to cyan, you could see here that this menu bar definitely is tinted cyan. Orange is definitely going to tint it orange. You can see here with the halftone background, it's definitely a different color than with the Catalina one. This may seem obvious to some people, but not to others. A lot of times I get people telling me, oh, they don't like the color of the menu bar, not realizing that the menu bar isn't colored at all. It's just semi-transparent. So if you don't like the color of it, change what's on your background, and then you'll see that reflected in transparent elements like the menu bar. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.